نجاتنا فتمسكي بعراه كي لا نغرقا.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. Welcome back to Alhamdulillah, what's been a very eventful day 5 of the quarterfinal rounds. Alhamdulillah, just before the break, we've now heard 7 of our participants today, and it's just judging by today's contestants, I know how difficult it's going to be for the judges, but I also know how interesting our semi-finals and our finals, inshallah, will be. Now, just for the benefit of those who may be tuning in now, just to announce again, inshallah, that obviously at the end of each quarterfinal, the winners or the contestants to go through to the semifinal are not announced, inshallah, but they will be announced live, inshallah, on the 3rd of April. So do keep that date in mind. And again, inshallah, the semifinals will be on the 9th and the 10th of April. The 9th will be for the under 13 age group, and the 10th of April will be obviously for the older age group. And then the finals will be on the 16th and the 17th of April, the 16th again being for the younger age group and the 17th for the older age group. And again, obviously we'd like to invite everyone, inshallah, to the award ceremony, which will be held at the London Muslim Center, which is East London Masjid, inshallah, on the 30th of April, where guest judge Sheikh Biladi, who is the Imam of Masjid Qiblatain in Medina, will be there, inshallah. So everyone is humbly requested and invited to, inshallah, take part. Now, inshallah, obviously let's move on to our next contestant, inshallah, who is 11-year-old Hussein Ahmed from London, inshallah. So if I can ask Hussein Ahmed, inshallah, to come to the stage. Assalamu alaikum, Hussein.
Wa alaikum salam.
How are you today?
Alhamdulillah.
Yeah? Now, listening to the first 7, how do you feel?
Very good.
Yeah? Do you feel it's going to be tough today?
Kind of.
Yeah? But are you prepared though? Yourself, yeah? MashaAllah. That's what we like to hear from everybody, inshallah. Excellent. Okay, Hussein, when you're ready, inshallah, you can begin your first recitation.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قال الملأ الذين استكبروا من قومي لنخرجنك يا شعيب والذين آمنوا معك من قريتنا أو لتعودن في ملتنا قال ولو كنا كارهين. قد افترينا على الله كذبا إن عدنا في ملتكم بعد إذ نجانا الله منها وما يكون لنا أن نعود فيها إلا أن يشاء الله ربنا وسع ربنا كل شيء علما على الله توكلنا ربنا افتح بيننا وبين قومنا بالحق وأنت خير الفاتحين. صدق الله العظيم.
ما شاء الله. Very, very confidently done, alhamdulillah. Is it easier normally when you close your eyes and you just pretend no one's there? Does that help, yeah? ما شاء الله. Now, Hussein, inshallah, when you're ready, you can give us your second recitation as well.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو عالم الغيب الشهادة والرحمن الرحيم هو الله الذي لا إله إلا هو الملك القدوس السلام المؤمن المهيمن المهيمن العزيز الجبار المتكبر سبحان الله عما يشركون هو الله الخالق البارئ المصور له الأسماء الحسنى يسبح له ما في السماوات والأرض وهو العزيز الحكيم صدق الله العظيم
ما شاء الله ما شاء الله جزاك الله خير حسين Is this the first time you're taking part in Q Factor? How do you feel?
Good,
yeah? Alhamdulillah ما شاء الله If I can start with the قاري شافي إن شاء الله your comment please.
ما شاء الله حسين أحمد your مجود style I really liked it. I could tell that there's something in there that needs to become that needs to come out. So if you, the more you practice inshallah the more perfect you will get. And you actually did quite well even in Murattal as well inshallah. May Allah accept you and hopefully you become a great qari inshallah.
Okay inshallah. Jazakallah khair for that. And you've come with your uncle is it today? Okay, inshallah. If we can have Hussein's uncle, inshallah.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullah. Jazakallah khair for joining us. What did you think?
Alhamdulillah, I think he's done very well to have come this far in the competition.
Yeah.
And to be in front of all these audience, plus everyone who's viewing it from home on telly.
Plus the other contestants. That pressure.
Course.
That's all added pressure as well.
Exactly.
So.
And being sort of so far in the pecking order, it gets a bit nervous towards the end. But alhamdulillah, I think he's done very well.
Very proud. MashaAllah. Jazakallah khair for coming and showing your support as well, inshallah. Hussein, Jazakallah khair, inshallah, for coming and reciting. Jazakallah khair. You can take it from here. Alaikum salam wa rahmatullah. MashaAllah, that was 11-year-old Hussein Ahmed from London. If we can now move on to our next contestant, inshallah. Who is 12-year-old Tahmid Khan, also from London, inshallah. So if I can ask Tahmid to come to the stage. Assalamu alaikum, Tahmid.
Wa alaikum assalam.
How are you today?
Alhamdulillah.
Good, yeah? What part of London are you coming from?
Bethnal Green.
Okay, inshallah. You don't have to be so shy about it. Don't worry, I'm not coming round. Inshallah. But how are you feeling today? You feeling confident?
Alhamdulillah.
Yeah? Is it quite nerve-wracking then, sitting there watching all the other contestants recite? Or does it make it easier for you because you know what your competition is like today?
It's more nerve-wracking.
But are you confident though? You've been preparing?
Alhamdulillah.
Yeah, Alhamdulillah. And who have you come with today?
My two brothers.
Your two brothers. Okay, Inshallah. Okay, Tahmid, when you're ready, Inshallah, you can begin with your first recitation.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لا أقسم بهذا البلد وأنت حل بهذا البلد ووالد وما ولد لقد خلقنا الإنسان في كبد أيحسب أن لن يقدر عليه أحد يقول أهلكت مالا لبدا أيحسب أن لم يره أحد ألم نجعل له عينين ولسانا وشفتين وهديناه النجدين فلاقتحم العقبة وما أدراك ما العقبة فك رقبة أو إطعام في يوم ذي مسغبة يتيما ذا مقربة أو مسكينا ذا متربة ثم كان من الذين آمنوا وتواصوا بالصبر وتواصوا بالمرحمة أولئك أصحاب الميمنة والذين كفروا بآياتنا هم أصحاب المشأمة عليهم نار مؤصدة صدق الله العظيم.
ما شاء الله, beautifully done that, Ahmed. If you'd like to now give us your second recitation, inshallah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لا أقسم بيوم القيامة ولا أيحسب الإنسان أن لن نجمع عظامه بلى قادرين على أن نسوي بنانه بل يريد الإنسان ليفجر أمامه يسأل أيان يوم القيامة فإذا برق البصر وخسف القمر وجمع الشمس والقمر يقول الإنسان يومئذ أين المفر كلا لا وزر إلى ربك يومئذ المستقر ينبأ الإنسان يومئذ بما قدم وأخر صدق الله العظيم.
ما شاء الله, ما شاء الله, very very beautifully done there, Tahmeed. How do you feel after that?
Alhamdulillah.
Good? Alhamdulillah, ما شاء الله. Sheikh Nasir, inshallah, your comments.
ما شاء الله, Tahmeed Khan, you done fantastic. You got a nice tone. I could see you're nervous, which is normal. Because if you're not nervous, that means you're not normal. Yeah, for your age, it's normal to be nervous. You know, we're sitting here feeling nervous. What's going to happen? I just wonder one day maybe someone's going to slip off that stage. Like, you know, that's how nervous I am. And if you start shaking too much, it's close. So, mashallah, apart from that, you've done very good. Couple of things. Yawming the maqraba. When you're doing the ikhfa, your tongue is coming out. And when we were students, our teacher used to make us hold a mirror in front of our face and see the facial movement. The thing is not supposed to happen. So sticking your tongue out where it doesn't belong is not right. So the with the there's two miskinang the in the same your tongue came out again. Faida bariqal basaru. Sad is tafkhim, full mouth. Ba isn't. That's impacting. The sad is impacting you on your ba, which shouldn't. Ba sa ba saru. Apart from that, alhamdulillah, you've done good. Practice well, and hopefully, inshallah, you'll be a good qari one day.
Inshallah. And qari Shafi.
Very briefly, alhamdulillah, first of all, you recited very nicely. And for some reason today, I'm getting very attracted to Mujawad for some reason. I'm not quite sure. But alhamdulillah, there's a really few guys, actually, the Mujawad recitation was very nice, nicely read. And you know, when you are reciting the when you are pronouncing mad munfasil, try to minimize it from 5 to 3 or 2 or 3, inshallah. Other than that, alhamdulillah, you did good.
Mashallah, mashallah, I'll accept it. Tahmid, who'd say you've come with your brother? Did you say?
Yes.
Yeah, if we can have Tahmid's brothers, inshallah. Do we have the mic there? Inshallah.
Assalamu alaikum.
Alaikum assalam wa rahmatullah. Jazakallah khair for joining us. What did you think of Tahmid's recitation there?
Alhamdulillah, I'm quite proud of him.
Just quite proud of him?
Very proud of him.
You've got some tough brothers, I tell you honestly. No, alhamdulillah, done very, very well. How's he been at home, generally?
He's been practicing day in, day out, so alhamdulillah, I'm quite proud of him. Like, he's taken the steps, and he's quite been he's been very eager to compete. So inshallah. It's always nice to see people competing with khair. So
yeah, mashallah. No, excellent. Alhamdulillah. Well, jazakallah khair. Obviously, you know, for the support that you guys are giving, you know, your family, your parents. And jazakallah khair for that, inshallah. So, very well done, Tahmin, inshallah.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullah. Mashallah, that was 12-year-old Tahmid Khan from London. Now, we've come to our final contestant for today, inshallah, who's come all the way from Sid Cup in Kent. So, if I can invite 11-year-old Nihan al-Bari to the stage, inshallah.
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam. How are you feeling today?
Alhamdulillah, I'm feeling good.
Yeah? MashaAllah. You know, you look like a twin of Abdul Wahid there, almost. Like, just without the glasses, I think you guys have been separated at birth or something. Now, alhamdulillah. How are you feeling today, Nihan? How does it feel like the last one to go? Is it quite nerve-wracking?
Yes.
But has it given you more time to practice on that seat?
Yeah, it has.
Yeah? But are you confident? You've been practicing well?
Yes, sir.
Yeah? MashaAllah. Okay, Nihan, when you're ready, inshallah, you can begin with your first recitation, inshallah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والطور وكتاب مسطور في رق منشور والبيت المعمور والسقف المرفوع والبحر المستور إن عذاب ربك لواقع إن عذاب ربك لواقع ما له من دافع يوم تمور السماء مورا وتسير الجبال سيرا فويل يومئذ للمكذبين الذين هم في خوض يلعبون يوم يدعون إلى نار جهنم دعا هذه النار التي كنتم بها تكذبون صدق الله العظيم.
ما شاء الله ما شاء الله. Very very well done there. And Nihan, inshallah, you'd like to give us your second recitation, inshallah.
Yeah.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والضحى والليل إذا سجى ما ودعك ربك وما قلى وللآخرة خير لك من الأولى ولسوف يعطيك ربك فترضى ألم يجدك يتيما فآوى ووجدك ضالا فهدى ووجدك عائلا فأغنى فأما اليتيم فلا تقهر وأما السائل فلا تنهر وأما بنعمة ربك فحدث صدق الله العظيم.
ما شاء الله ما شاء الله. May Allah accept your recitation, Nihan. Qari Shafi, inshallah, your comments please.
MashaAllah, Nihan, you have recited very, very nicely. MashaAllah, you have this soft, eloquent voice that you have inside of you. But also, I think there's something inside of you, like this other brother that I told, that it's not coming out. I think it's because either you're nervous or your confidence was a bit low. But there is something better than the way you recited. I think you could have done better. Alhamdulillah, you did do good. I'm not saying you didn't do good. One thing that I want you to make sure you don't do this again, because it is a lahn jalim mistake. فَأَمَّا الْيَاتِيمَ. It's a فَأَمَّا الْيَاتِيمَ. You added a letter. After the ya, there's a ta, not an alif. So if you could make sure you don't make that mistake, inshallah, again.
Jazakallah khair. Sheikh Nasir.
MashaAllah, Nihalul Bari. Nihanul Bari. Difficult pronouncing. But one thing is, when
you might have not got the makhraj right there.
Yeah, well, in name, yeah, thank you, but in name, tajweed doesn't apply. That's why I'm lucky. Otherwise, Nihalul Bari. Nihanul Bari. Anyway, you've got a beautiful tone.
Yeah,
yes, mashallah. Very nice and soft, mashallah. Very good. Another thing is confidence about you. You made a mistake, lawakir. Then he had the confidence of going back and pronouncing the qaf properly. Yeah. It shows this is confidence. One thing, dafi', there is a close, as Ustad said before, between ta and dal. You're going in between. This few here and there needs to be worked on. Yatima, he's covered. Apart from that, yes, mujawad. I didn't really find the mujawad. It seemed like both of them are murattal, because both of them come in the same tone, same speed. If you're going to do mujawad, sit with your teacher and practice on mujawad a bit more, and inshallah, you'll do great. Inshallah, inshallah, inshallah.
And Nihan, who have you come with today?
My mom, my sister, little brother.
And okay, mashallah. So no pressure today, yeah? Okay, mashallah. Jazakallah khair. So you're Nihan's mom, right?
I'm Nihan's
okay.
mom.
Okay, what did you think of his recitation?
And alhamdulillah, he did so well. This is the first time he's been here in Q Factor, and I'm very proud of him. Obviously, the constructive feedback that, you know, everyone's getting from the teachers, if they take you on board, I'm sure they will go a long way in life.
Definitely.
And I'm very proud.
Yeah, no, you must be. Yeah. Alhamdulillah, he's done very, very well. And honestly, you know, when he started his first recitation, the Murattal, he has a very mellow, very sweet, soft voice, which is very nice. Very nice. Keep it up, and obviously just take the feedback that you're getting, inshallah, on board. And obviously you guys keep supporting, inshallah.
Inshallah.
And
yes.
I'm sure he will go very, very far one day, inshallah.
Inshallah.
But jazakallah khair for coming. Nihan, jazakallah khair.
Assalamu
alaikum. Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullah. Inshallah, that was 11-year-old Nihan al-Bari from Sid Cup in Kent, inshallah. Now, alhamdulillah, we have come to the end of today's episode. Now, if I can start with Khalid Shafi, inshallah, for your sort of general feedback of how you found today's
the overall feedback that I would like to say to everyone, alhamdulillah, every single person recited here very nicely, very, very nicely. Otherwise, you wouldn't have been in quarterfinals. So the judges must have seen something whilst you were doing the live audition, and that's why you're in quarterfinals. So one thing that I want everyone to remember very clearly is whenever you are reciting, guys, every time you're reciting, always remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is very, very important in life. Anything that you do, it has to be only for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even we are judging, end of the day, we will be judged in the day of Qiyamah, that how did you judge? We'll be judged by the judge of all judges. Do you understand? So anything that you do in life, always appreciate the way you are. And I would like to thank all the parents especially, that because of you guys, because of the parents, that the children are doing this. Otherwise the children wouldn't have the confidence if the parents didn't help them or encourage them. Like Brother Azam Iqbal did. I'm sure his father was sick, but his father told him all to come all the way from Birmingham all alone. Alhamdulillah. So this is encouragement from the parents. So inshallah, if the parents could carry on doing this, continue doing this. I remember, if you don't go through the semi-finals, don't give up on reciting the Quran or perfecting your Quran. Inshallah. Carry on until the day everyone leaves this world, inshallah.
Inshallah. Sheikh Nasir?
Alhamdulillah. Sitting here and judging is very difficult, yes. Especially when you have a group of contestants, very talented and beautiful, like the ones we have here and in the past as well, mashallah. Each and every, we are critical, yes. It doesn't mean you didn't recite good. Because to come through to this round, you are good enough, mashallah. But we are here to help you improve on what you have. So that's our aim. Inshallah. Winning the competition is nothing. Because only one person wins. It doesn't mean rest of them are not good enough. Yes? I say the one who wins is lucky. On that day, rest of them gave him the chance. All right, you go and win it. We don't want it that much. Alhamdulillah, we are all the students of the Quran. Yes? We are here, we are either studying or teaching. And this is the best, according to the hadith of Prophet ﷺ, خَيْرُكُمْ مَنْ تَعَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنَ وَعَلَّمَ. The best amongst you are those who study the Quran and teach the Quran. And not only studying and teaching. We, alhamdulillah, maybe many of you are students of Hifz here. You become in Hafiz. Your parents are so proud and happy. Yes, I hear every time when a student finishes the Quran, mashallah, teachers, they applaud him, which they should. The parents also do, which they should, because when someone gets graduated from university colleges, they chuck that this triangle or rectangle hat in the sky and take a picture. Yes, but when it comes to becoming Hafiz, we don't even say mashallah. We don't even buy him a gift, which is, I believe, degrading to the Quran, which should happen more and more. So regardless whatever happens, I know parents are supporting these beautiful and young talented children. You should continue doing this. You're not only supporting them, you are helping build the lifestyle according to the Quran into them as well. Sure. You're encouraging them so that they become a role model. They become a person who follows the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, whose life was according to the Quran itself. So that's why encourage these youngsters. Give them motivation, give them incentive. Yes, you finish your juz, this is a bonus for you. Sure. Yes, give them that. When he gets good marks in GCSEs, we see iPads and iPhones and everything coming in. Yet when he becomes Hafiz, okay, mashallah, that shouldn't be it. Let's encourage them, give it more status, which it has. Quran has more status over everything. It is the best thing man can get. Sure. But having said that, just becoming Hafiz, I get diverted too quick. Just becoming Hafiz isn't good enough. Yes, if you become Hafiz, you could take 10 people to Jannah and all this. Yes, this hadith has another section. Practicing what is good and abstaining from what is bad. Everyone misses that out. Hafiz, just become Hafiz, is going to take 10 people to Jannah. As well as becoming Hafiz, let's make our character according to the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and inshallah then we can hope and we can take 10, not only 10, more than that into Jannah. May inshallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it possible. Amen. To practice what has been said. Jazakumullah khair.
Jazakumullah khair to our beloved judges for that, inshallah. So jazakumullah khair to everyone of the coming for today, you know, coming today, to the contestants for taking part, to the families for coming and supporting. Obviously, just bear in mind the 3rd of April, obviously, where all the winners, inshallah, will be announced. But until then, obviously, keep practicing, because obviously, like the sheikhs have said, the ultimate aim is not to obviously go through to the semi-final. It's always nice. It's always nice to go through the competition at the end of the day. But the ultimate aim is obviously to seek the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And inshallah, you know, you guys are doing that. And so inshallah, keep up with that inshallah. You know, for those of you who have your one-to-one teachers, obviously keep up with that. For those of you who don't, inshallah, do that. But, you know, just keep practicing inshallah. And I'm sure we'll see many of you, if not all inshallah, through to the semi-finals. But do have a safe journey home inshallah for all of you. Jazakallah khair to our judges. For coming inshallah and giving our nasiha inshallah. And jazakallah khair for everyone for watching inshallah. And until tomorrow, which is day 6 inshallah of the quarterfinal rounds, do look after yourself. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
يا